الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وأزواجه وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، العقيدة الواسطية لشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية. Today is the 18th of Safar 1432, sorry, which corresponds to the 22nd of January. You don't say 22, you say 22nd of January 2011. This one of the classes I teach in English. Anyways, الأمر الرابع مما يكون يوم القيامة. The fourth matter concerning that which will occur on the day of resurrection. ما ذكره المؤلف رحمه الله بقوله ويلجمهم العرق. That which the author had mentioned, may Allah have mercy on him, and sweat or perspiration will يلجمهم. How am I going to translate that? Basically it is the bridle. I want you to imagine a horse and they put that thing around its mouth so they can control it going left and right or what have you. So basically it's that which makes it to the face or the mouth and nose area. And the araq, which is sweat, one's own sweat, will reach up to one's mouth and nose, just like the bridle is around a horse or a camel or what have you. Question, grammatical question, let's see how much Arabic you guys have been retaining or attaining. يلجمهم العرق or يلجمهم العرق or يلجمهم العرق. Which one is correct? So what does it end with? Why? Mm-hmm. Huh? Well, you guys attend in the same class, right? What's up with this discrepancy? What senior, ya Sheikh? Alhamdulillah. And what are you, junior? طبعاً بالضمة. But why is it مرفوع? How do you know it's مرفوع? مبتدا يلجمهم is the فعل. The fa'il, the doer, the subject of the sentence, the one who does the action, the one who does the verb, is always marfu'. Remember? So if you say يلجمهم العرق, that will distort the meaning because that makes it maf'ul bihi. It makes it the object of the sentence, and then we're missing the fa'il. This is very important in the language, in the Arabic language. You can't be taking these matters lightly. Because if you read the Quran and Allah Azza wa Jal is the doer of an action, and you, instead of putting Dhamma, you put Fatha, you made the action happening to Allah. For example, إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. يخشى الله. Now Allah لفظ جل is the object of the sentence. The one, the subject is علماء. That's why you have to say علماء أو, and you have to say يخشى الله ها. If you say يخشى الله, now you have made Allah the subject of the sentence, thus He is the doer of the action, and the علماء becomes the مفعول به. Disaster. Kufr. Unintentional kufr, but it's kufr. So that's why we need to really يعني, get a good hang of this Arabic language.
What? مفعول به.
No, it's not called Fataha. It's called Fataha is the fa'al madi of Fataha. Fataha. Maftuh, if you want to describe it, the adjective is Maftuh. Open. Like Al-Babu Maftuh. Mansub, of course, in this case, exactly. But it ends with a Fataha. Fataha. Fataha is he opened. Fataha al-waladu al-baba. Fataha. Make a distinction. طيب. The Shaykh said, يلجمهم أن يصل منهم إلى موضع اللجام من الفرس وهو الفرد. It means it makes it to the place where the bridle is placed up on the horse, and that is the mouth. ولكن هذا غاية ما يصل إليه العرق. But this is the highest limit to which the sweat will make it. It won't make it beyond that. وَإِلَّا otherwise, فَبَعْضُهُمْ يَصِلُ الْعَرَقِ إِلَى كَعْبَيْهِ. Some of them, the sweat will make it up to their what? كعب. Ankles. كعبين. ما أسفل من الإزار من الكعبين. ما أسفل من الكعبين من الإزار ففي النار. Memorize يا جماعة الخير. Memorize. وإلى ركبتيه. ورد ركب. ركبتان. The knees. وإلى حقويه.
حقويه.
نعم. Probably the waist. Not the one I'm familiar. They usually use another word for it. خصر. But perhaps this is more eloquent and more grammatically or more linguistically correct. ومنهم من يلجمه فهم يختلفون في هذا العرق. And among them are those who the sweat will be up to their mouth. So there's a variation in that amongst them in terms of to what level the sweat will make it. ويعرقون من شدة الحر. Why will they be sweating? Because it's very cold.
Sun is very close.
It's getting very hot. They will be very hot. لأن المقام مقام زحام وشدة ودنو شمس. Because the situation is that of traffic, if we may call it. Zahma is actually crowded. The crowdedness. It's crowdedness. Shidda, severity, severe situation, tough situation. ودنو شمس, and the nearness of the sun. The nearness of the sun. فيغرق الإنسان مما يحصل في ذلك اليوم لكنهم على حسب عملهم. So then the people drown in their perspiration and their sweat according to their on that day, but each according to their deeds. They will not all be the same. فإن قلت كيف يكون ذلك وهم في مكان واحد. Someone may want to apply rationalism. Everything must make sense. If someone says to you, how is that going to happen while all of them are in the same place? How is someone's, the sweat is going to be to his ankles, one to his knees, one to his waist, one to his mouth, and they're all in the same place. How is there going to be this kind of variation in the depth or the height of the water? Or the sweat, I'm sorry. فالجواب أننا أصلنا قاعدة يجب الرجوع إليها. We have already founded a principle to which we must refer. We must return. وهي أن الأمور الغيبية يجب علينا أن نؤمن بها ونصدق دون أن نقول كيف ولما. What is that principle? The matters of the unseen are those which we are obliged to believe in, without asking how or why. Don't ask, because you don't know, and you will never know until you are living these moments. Now it's part of the unseen, which Allah didn't reveal the details, didn't reveal. So asking about it is called in Arabic tanattu', extremism. تنطر. هلك المتنطئ. The Prophet ﷺ spoke about them. They have destroyed themselves. The متنطعون. Those who go to extremism and want to make a big deal out of things which the deen had left, you know, simplified. These are these individuals. تنطر. Very dangerous. متطرف here is usually used in the context of someone who takes the text into another extreme. Usually in the context of jihad, when they want to speak about someone who's involved in military action, then they say he's mutatarrif. That particular term, as far as I know, is not used by the Quran and the Sunnah. It's used by people against the Muslims, but the mutanatti is used by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So mutatarrif is like fundamentalists. You know, they call him fundamentalist, which is good. You're supposed to be a fundamentalist. You stick to the fundamentals. But nowadays it's used as with a negative connotation. Anyways. أرأيت نعم لأنها شيء وراء عقولنا. Because it's a matter that is beyond our intellect. ولا يمكن أن ندركها أو نحيط بها. It is impossible that we will be able to comprehend it or encompass it. Excuse me. أرأيت لو أن رجلين دفنا في قبر واحد أحدهما مؤمن والثاني كافر. Do you see if two men were buried in one grave, one of them is a believer whilst the other is a kafir, فإنه ينال المؤمن من النعيم ما يستحق. The believer will acquire or receive of bliss and delight what he deserves. وينال الكافر من العذاب ما يستحق. And the disbeliever will attain and receive of punishment what he deserves. وهما في قبر واحد while they are in one grave. وهكذا نقول في العرق يوم القيامة. Similarly we say concerning the sweat on the day of resurrection. Is that understood? Is the principle understood? Anytime someone brings you a misconception about the affairs of the life to come, how come this, how is that going to happen, say listen, it is not like this world. It's not going to be like what you've seen in this world. It's something from the unseen. You just believe in it. It wasn't meant to be understood in the full context in this life. This is, you know, otherwise Allah would have explained it. خلاص, disbelieve. فإن قلت هل تقول إن الله سبحانه وتعالى يجمع من يلجمه من العرق في مكان ومن يصل إلى كعبيه في مكان وإلى ركبتيه في مكان ولحقيه في مكان. If you say then do you say that Allah will then gather maybe all those whose sweat will be up to their mouths in one place, and those who the sweat will be up to their ankles in one place, those to their knees and their waists? Is that what you're saying? Maybe, you know, someone's still trying to rationalize that everybody will be in a section. This is a section of those to their mouths, so all of them will be together, then it will make sense. But if they were all standing next to each other, one to his knees, one to his ankles, one to his mouth, then becomes a problem in the dunya, of course. فالجواب لا نجزم بهذا. We cannot conclude that. جزم is to be يعني confirm, to have certainty in something. أجزم أن كذا وكذا, meaning I have no doubt that such will happen, right? جزم. Anyways, that you learn that in grammar as well. مجزوم, right? That you know it. What happens to the end of the verb?
مجزوم.
Hey, what happens to the end of it? It ends with a sukun. If it's a consonant, if it ends with a consonant, if it ends with a harf illa, كسر يا سلام والله لازم كسرك يا محمد.
Before I say, if it comes out here,
if it ends with waw, ya, or alif, and it's مجزوم, what happens to it? If it ends with ضمة فتحة كسرة, for example, whatever, it becomes سكون. It becomes سكون. لم يدرس الولد, for example. Well, he is going to be لم يدرس الولد because of the ساكن الولد. لم يدرس محمد. لم يدرس. طيب. The سين is حرف صحيح. It's a consonant. It's a correct. Now, حرف العلة, the vowel, like تأتي, لم تأتي. You omit the حرف العلة and you keep the smaller vowel of it instead. You with me? The حرف العلة is gone. What book are you guys taking in Arabic? This has nothing to do with it now. Yeah, but this has nothing to do with jazm. Inna is not ada jazm. Now, yes, but you're in the other valley. We're speaking about, we have the nasb, marfu', mansub, majroor, and majzoom. Now, the majroor is strictly for the asma, for the nouns. The verbs, it's either mansub, like hatta yatiya abi, hatta yatiya. Because of hatta, يأتي بك أنزو ذي فتحة يأتي أنزو ذي فتحة because it's منصوب مجزوم you emit ذي حرف العلة حتى يأتي not حتى here لم يأتي أبي يأتي you don't say يأتي the ياء is gone because it's مجزوم you get me? Now yes ربي ربي correct but that's, that has nothing to do with the فعل that's an اسم we speak about the أفعال ماشي؟ Look for them in the Quran, you will find many examples. Inshallah. Always when you read the Quran, read it from numerous angles and you try to look into the language so you can, it's a form of practicing, inshallah, through that which you have learned with the Shaykh already. طيب. لا نجزم بهذا, we don't end, you know, conclude it decisively that this is the case. والله أعلم, Allah knows best. بل نقول, rather we say, من الجائز أن يكون الذي يصل العرق إلى كعبيه إلى جانب الذي يلجمه العرق. It is possible that the one whose sweat is up to his ankle will be right next to the one whose sweat is up to his mouth. والله على كل شيء. And Allah is able to do all things. وهذا نظير النور الذي يكون للمؤمنين. And this is similar to the light which will be given to the believers. يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم it will be before, their, before them and on their rights والكفار في ظلمة and the disbelievers will be in darkness فيوم القيامة يجب علينا أن نؤمن به وبما يكون فيه أما كيف ولما فهذا ليس علينا so the day of resurrection we need to believe in what concerning it and what happens in it without how or why this is none of our business ليس لنا it's not our business not our affair not our concern so that was the fourth matter the fifth matter مما يكون الأمر الخامس مما يكون يوم القيامة ما ذكره بقوله فتنصب الموازين فتوزن بها أعمال العباد فتنصب الموازين تنصب is what? What kind of verb is it? مبني للمجهول أحسنت أحسنت مبني للمجهول In English we call it the passive voice In English you have the active voice Ahmed ate the apple The passive voice is the apple was eaten No, no, you don't have to mention Ahmed you can but the importance here is that the apple was eaten not who did it Ford was established in 1952 your emphasis is the company Ford John Ford or George Ford whatever established the company now the emphasis on the one who did it the subject usually use in English the past participle driven, eaten, gotten, ridden, what have you as opposed to the simple past in Arabic it's the majhul قتل الخراصون قتل الإنسان ما أكفره قتل it's not قتل or يقتل قتل may he be killed or what it really means here in the ayah in the Quran usually may he be cursed So it's mabni, the one doing the action is not mentioned. It's damir mustatir. It's hidden. The pronoun is hidden, but we understand it from the context. Yeah, it's a passive voice. Here, فَتُنْصَبُ الْمَوَازِينُ Why?
Act like five, not four.
But it's not مفعول به موازين is what here you will learn this in the future this is called نائب فاعل it confuses the people because you think that the action the doer is someone else so you think that the موازين is the مفعول به but actually they call it نائب فاعل and it takes the same ruling it's also مرفوع فتنصب الموازين فتوزن also بها أعمال العباد the same thing توزنو passive voice it would be weighed it doesn't mention who so what does that mean تنصب الموازين the scales will be set up the scales will be set up, and the deeds of the slaves will be weighed on them. Excuse me. الذي, now here we know it was passive, but now we're going to know. الذي ينصب الموازين هو الله. Who? الذي ينصب الموازين مفعول به now. ينصب is the فعل. موازين is مفعول به هو الله. Allah is the one doing it. If you mess around and say الذي ينصب الموازين هو الله, then you have made the meaning exactly the opposite. You made the scales the one way. أعوذ بالله. You see how technical it is? That's the value of the Arabic language. Allah, the small haraka will send you will send you a long distance. Yeah, but see, if you were to speak correctly, if you ever want to speak Arabic, then all these must be taken into consideration. Otherwise, if you start throwing vowels the way you like, you will be changing the meaning. Now when you read, it's not a big deal. You're going to read, if the book has the vowels, big deal. But when you're reading a book that doesn't have vowels, you must understand now what goes where. Huh? Yes. What about them? بدون حركات. Most books are بدون حركات يا شيخ. Unless they quote an ayah or a hadith. Even the hadith you find, often find it with no حركات. You have to make your own حركات. طيب. That shouldn't يعني put you down or make you feel that this, no, this should make you strive more. It's not impossible. It's lovely when you know it though. It feels good. So the one who places the scales is Allah Azza wa Jal, لِتُوزَن بِهَا عَمَالُ الْعِبَادِ, so that the deeds of the slaves will be weighed on it. Excuse me. فَمِثَالُ, now المؤلف رحمه الله يقول الموازين. Now the author, may Allah have mercy on him, said موازين. موازين, is it singular, dual or plural? What's the singular? سورة الرحمن. الرحمن علم القرآن, خلق الإنسان, علمه البيان, الشمس والقمر بحسبان, والنجم والشجر يسجدان, والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان, ألا تطغوا في الميزان. The singular is ميزان. إذن, but so the مؤلف used موازين, the plural. And there's other verb, موزن, موزن, الله أعلم. Now I'm saying on one element, but you find that it's very complicated sometimes, the morphology of the words. على كل حال بالجمع وقد وردت النصوص بالجمع الإفراد. However, textual evidences do mention both the plural and the singular. فمثال الجمع, example of the plural, قوله تعالى ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة. And we place the scales or the balances of justice for the day of resurrection. وقال تعالى والوزن يومئذ الحق. The scale on that day is the way of the truth. The truth will be weighed. The weights on that day are the true weights. Alright? فمن ثقلت موازينه فأولئك هم المفلحون. Whosoever scales are heavy, it is those who are successful. وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. As for those whose scales are light, or they're not, hold on, what was the first one? But they call it heavy. They're light, then it is those who have wronged or lost themselves. خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. وَأَمَّا الْإِفْرَاد, as for the إِفْرَاد, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كلمتان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن. This is a beautiful hadith if you memorize it. كلمتان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن, خفيفتان على الميزان, خفيفتان على اللسان, ثقيلتان في الميزان, سبحان الله وبحمده, سبحان الله العظيم. Two words, beloved to the most merciful, light on the tongue, heavy on the scale. And these two words are, glory be to Allah and all praises due to Him, glory be to Allah the Great. Now the Shaykh quoted a hadith even though we found an ayah. Perhaps at the time the Shaykh didn't think of that ayah. But the ayah Surah Rahman also mentions mizan. But maybe that mizan is different than that mizan, that's why the Shaykh didn't quote it. Because that mizan that Allah spoke about, وَوَضَعْنَا الْمِيزَانِ is the mizan of what? The dunya. The scale of the dunya of justice. These are the mawazin of يوم القيامة. That's different. Maybe that's why the Shaykh didn't quote it. على كل حال فقال في الميزان فأفرس. So he used the singular في الميزان in the scale. Or نعم. فكيف نجمع بين الآيات القرآنية وبين هذا الحديث. How is it then that we can harmonize between the Quranic ayat and the tradition of the Prophet ﷺ, the hadith? How are we going to bring a relation between them? The ayah says mawazin, scales. The hadith says mizan, scale. Which one is it? Scales or scale? Makes a difference, doesn't it? If I told you I bought one scale, or I told you I bought 10 scales, or I bought scales, that's a big difference.
Because of the
cold. Hey. Even if it's two, that's still a lot. We'll see. فالجواب أن نقول, the answer is that we say, إنها جمعت باعتبار الموزون حيث أنه متعدد. It has been pluralized in consideration of the object which is weighed. The reason why it's pluralized is because of the actual things weighed, not the scale itself. Because it's numerous. Numerous things are being weighed. وَأُفْرِدَتْ بِاعْتِبَارَ أَنَّ الْمِيزَانَ وَاحِدْ أَوْ مِيزَانَ كُلُّ أُمَّةٍ. But it was used in the singular in consideration of the fact that it is one scale or the scale of one ummah. So when he spoke of one scale on which deeds are put, he said mizan. When the ayah spoke of mawazin, it was used in the plural sense, in the plural form, because it was speaking about that which is weighed and not the scale itself. Do you comprehend or are you confused?
He's talking about the things which is going to weigh.
When we spoke about, when Allah spoke about the things which will be weighed, which are numerous, He said mawazin. And the plural was used to refer to the many things which will be weighed.
Not the scales.
Not the scales. Even, there is the scales, but because many things will be weighed on them, the plural was used. However, in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, because the mizan is one, then he used the singular. Or because it's the mizan of the ummah, each ummah will have its own scale in that regard. That's one of the interpretations. أو أن المراد بالميزان في قوله صلى عليه الصلاة والسلام ثقيلتان في الميزان أي في الوزن. Or what could be intended by mizan in the statement of the Prophet ﷺ, heavy in the scale or on the scale, is in wazn, meaning in weight, their weight. ولكن الذي يظهر والله أعلم أن الميزان واحد. The Shaykh said, however, what seems to be what is apparent or what is strong is that there's one scale, not many scales, one scale. وأنه جمع باعتبار الموزون, but it was pluralized at time in consideration or in reference to that which is weighed. بدليل قوله تعالى فمن ثقلت موازينه, because Allah said whoever scales are heavy. لكن يتوقف الإنسان, however the person should stop. هل يكون ميزانا واحدا لجميع الأمم أو لكل أمة ميزان. Will there be one scale for all nations or will every nation have its own scale? لأن الأمم كما دلت عليه النصوص تختلف باعتبار أجرها. Because these nations, as the textual evidences indicate, their rewards are various. The rewards are different. The Ummah of the Prophet ﷺ has the most rewards in comparison to other Ummah. for the deeds which they do. This is from the bounty of Allah upon the Ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وقوله تنصب الموازين, the scales will be placed, ظاهر أن موازين حسية. The apparent meaning is that they are tangible scales. يعني the speech can be figurative, it can be figurative or it can be literal, the literal meaning of the word. For example, I say, you know, you write an essay and I will weigh your skills, your writing skills. Now, I'm not going to go to the, you know, supermarket and say, excuse me, these are the skills of my English student. Let me just see how much they weigh here on the thing and say, okay, they're just half a kilo. Right? I mean by that, I will weigh as in I will evaluate. In English, they say, weigh it out. يعني consider the situation. Somebody, shall I go to Medina, shall I stay, shall I go to, they're confused. Say, weigh out your options. Weigh out your options. Now, they don't mean it in a literal sense. You will not be weighing anything out, really. It's a figurative speech. Right?
Balance your life.
Ahsant. Balance your life. It doesn't mean you're going to get a balance and put 2 kilos here and then you sit on the other side. Right? These are expressions that the people use. They're not meant in the literal sense. It's figure of speech. It's no. So now the question is, are these scales real? Or is it just some idea? Is it figurative? وَأَنَّ الْوَزْنِ يَكُونَ عَلَى حَسَبِ الْمَعْهُودِ بِالْرَاجِحِ وَالْمَرْجُوحِ. And the fact that weighs or the weight will be according to what is standard to us, and what is preponderant, and that which is preponderant has been preponderant over, if this is correct English. Very difficult to translate that. وَذَلِكَ لِأَنَّ الْأَصْلَ فِي الْكَلِمَاتِ الْوَارِدَ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ حَمْلُهَا عَلَى الْعَهْدِ الْمَعْرُوفِ. Why? Because the principle in Islam is that whatever we see in the Quran and Sunnah, we accept it according to the tangible, real standards, to what is known to us. We don't give it a subliminal or a figurative meaning. We stick to the literal meaning of the word. إِلَّا إِذَا قَامَ الدَّلِيلَ عَلَنَا إِخْلَافَ ذَلِكَ unless the evidence indicates otherwise. وَالْمَعْهُودِ الْمَعْرُوفِ عِنْدَ الْمُخَاطَبِينَ مُنْذُ نُزُولِ الْقُرْآنِ الْكَرِيمِ إِلَى الْيَوْمِ أَنَّ الْمِيزَانِ حَسِّي. From the time the Quran was revealed until today, what is known amongst us is that scale is something tangible. They have it in the supermarket. They weigh out the vegetables even in front of the masjid. The brother selling you fruits and vegetables has a scale. He puts it in, says 1 kilo, you give him the 3 riyals for the whatever you just bought. Nowadays it's no longer 3 riyals. Minimum 5 riyals and more. Allah musta'an.
2 kilo.
Yeah, mashi halam. وَأَنَّ هُنَالِكَ رَاجِحٌ وَمَرْجُوحٌ. So then there's something that is rajih, meaning it's rajih, the deal of rajih, meaning that in English it's a very technical term, preponderant. Preponderant means the most correct answer, the most correct position. Marjuh is the answer which has been favored over. Yani, we have two opinions among the scholars. One, that covering the face is obligatory, while the other is that it's only recommended. If you follow the position, if you're convinced, or if the stronger position that covering the face is the stronger, you say, الراجح, not راجحي, don't be thinking about banks. الراجح is that you must cover the face. الرأي المرجوح, the opinion which has been defeated in the sense, meaning it is not as strong as the other one, is called مرجوح. You with me? You hear this in the fatwa. If you listen to the ulama, you hear them say often, والراجح من أقوال العلماء أنه كذا وكذا وكذا. And the strongest opinion among the same of the scholars is such and such and such. طيب, inshallah, I am leaning towards departure, if I may. Subhanakallahumma hamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.